Good morning, everybody. It's Paul. It's Beardacus. Thank you for joining me in my shop today. Now, I am something of a music lover. I'm a fanatic about music. I listen to music all the time. If it's not on, it's in my head. Sometimes it's really, really annoying. It just plays over and 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 over again, and I can't get it out of me. Different story, but I do. I love music, and I don't just listen to the music. When I listen to music, I have to learn everything I can about the artist. I have to try to dissect every instrument and every nuance of the song, learn the lyrics. What do they mean? Not just what the artist meant, but what does it mean to me? It's a deep onion of possible insanity. Maybe insanity. Jury's out on that. But I was stuck in a rut for a long time, and listened to good artists, you know, 21 Pilots and different artists. But I listened to just a handful of them over and over and over again, and it drove me a little bit mad. So I got out of the rut. Now, I have been exploring. I've been finding some amazing artists. Foy Vance, Passenger, Kaleo, just of Monsters and Men. And, a bunch of great new artists. But I've gotten back into a rut again, and I have about six that I listen to on a regular basis. And I don't want to be out of the rut. I love my rut. My rut is good. We're staying in the rut. But the top of the list of the rut right now is a English artist named Michael Kiwanuka. I'm a big fan. And so here's a little bit of his music. I believe she won't take me somewhere I'm not supposed to be. You can't steal the things that God has given me. No more pain and no more shame and misery. And here's a little more. Hopefully they're not going to take down my video for that. So I want to make something commemorating my appreciation for this dude's artistry. I've done that before, 21 Pilots, and then with Passenger. And today I am going to make a 14-inch by 20-inch just wall art. And it's going to be a silhouette. I'm going to take a picture. I'm going to cut it out in Photoshop. I'm going to turn it into a silhouette. And I'm going to just design something cool, and you are going to go along with me for the ride. And a first step, though, of course, is I'm going to have you hit the like button. That's good for me. It's good for you. Your soul will feel gratified. You might grow a better beard. It's possible. And then subscribe to my channel. And now let's get going. Okay, so we're going to Vectric V-Carve Pro, which is what I use. And we're going to set the width to 20, the height to 14, and the thickness to half inch. We're just setting up our canvas here, and that's what I'll work with here in a moment. But after this, now we're going to go to Google. We're going to go and search some images. We're going to find the perfect image that I can use to make a silhouette. So we'll type Michael Kiwanuka, we'll go to the images tab. I'm looking for something with a really cool vibe to it, a really interesting feel, maybe a live sort of performance look, and that right there is it. So we're going to copy that image and go to Photoshop, paste it, and then we're going to get the handy dandy pen tool. I love this tool. This tool makes a very tedious job a lot easier. And so now we'll just click little points all around the image of Michael Kiwanuka just to select him totally. Now, I'm going to speed it up here because this is a seriously tedious thing to do. I hate doing this, but again, the pen tool makes it easier. I'm not looking for perfection here, by the way. I can come in later and clean it up. And with the silhouette that I'm looking for, perfection really isn't necessary at all. So once that's done, we'll select that, make that a selection, cut it out, delete the background, and paste it back in there. And then we'll go through and we'll do just a little bit of cleanup work. There's a few little areas or a couple of little areas that need to be deleted. And then once that's done, I'll use the blending mode and I'll do a color overlay, and then all I'll have left is now a black silhouette of Michael Kiwanuka. Put it over there, paste it over there onto VCarve Pro again, and then I'll use a little tool there to turn that into a vector. That way my CNC has something that it can work with. And delete the original, and there you go, guys. There is my vector silhouette of Michael Kiwanuka playing the guitar live. So I'll just kind of get it scaled the way I want it, and then moved over to the left. There you go. And there you go. That's it. So now I want some vertical lines running all along the picture. But in order to do that, I want them to be spaced exactly. So what I'm going to do is to create some rectangles, 3-inch wide and then a 1-inch wide rectangle. And I'm going to get them positioned on this and then duplicate them just all the way down. And that way I will have a guide to work with. Now, if I just left them as rectangles, what would happen is the tool would come and it would carve out a rectangle. And I don't want that. So I am going to now go in with the line tool and just draw a single line over each line there, and then delete the rectangles. And what I'm left with are a bunch of lines that are evenly spaced all along the picture. And now the tool will just cut out that one line, which is pretty cool. I'll use a profile on that. And anyway, the profile toolpath, that is. All right, so now we're gonna use Oliver font, which I really love. Oliver is it's kind of a retro sort of font. I dig it. I think Michael Kiwanuka has a retro feel, kind of Marvin Gaye, 60s, 70s, I like that. And so I will type Kiwanuka out just like that and get the letters positioned exactly where I want them. And then that is it. That is my design. Now I need to set up some tool paths so that my CNC knows what to cut. So like I said, with the lines, we're doing a profile tool. We're using an 1/8-inch compression bit, which should leave a pretty clean line all the way down. That's the tool path for the lines. And then we're going to go ahead and select Kiwanuka and the silhouette of Michael Kiwanuka, so the letters and the silhouette, and we're going to do a V carve on this using a 45 degree V bit. But then I will also use a compression bit once again just to clear out all the excess material. If I had the 45 degree bit do all of that work, it would take hours, and there's no reason to do that. So that's it. I mean, that is my design altogether. If you take a look at it, it's pretty stinking fantastic. Look at that. That is cool. Man, I like that design. So now we're going to get some wood. We're going to get it cut, painted. It's going to be awesome. So keep on watching, all right? There it is, a weird thing that I have created. I'm gonna stop now. All right, so there it is. The finished piece. Is it what I was looking for? I don't really know. I think I didn't have a good sense of what I had in mind. When I started it, I knew I wanted some 60s, 70s sort of color, because his music, even though it is new, I think his latest album came out last year, it has very Marvin Gaye 70s feel to it. So I thought of that, and I kind of had that color palette in mind, but when I started mixing, it just took on a life of its own, and so it is what it is. But so what we're gonna do now, I have two tool paths for this. I have a 45 degree tool path, but I have a clearance tool path first. It's the compression bit, which is an eighth of an inch, and it will come through and it'll clear out the material that it can, leaving the rest to be cleared out and carved by the 45 degree tool bit. And that saves me some time and a lot of wear and tear on the 45 degree bit, so the V bit. So first thing first, we're gonna do the compression bit. When that's done, come back, switch out to the 45 degree bit and get the rest of it done. We'll see what it looks like. I forgot to mention that what I did come back and put a couple of coats of a triple thick clear glossy finish on this, which will protect the paint, so it's possible to touch it and everything without a problem. And the bit's not going to drag across the surface of it, so I'm not worried about it damaging the surface unless things go wrong, and things can go wrong. So just didn't film that part, but I'd let you know. Looking pretty good. All right, so after I had completed the carve, I sanded off all the little bits. I know I didn't film at all, I'm sorry. But then I sprayed some crystal clear glaze. I would use shellac, that's another good one, but this is what I had on hand. And then I passed it over to my wife, who did some detailed painting work on it. And then I collaborated with her. Didn't plan on doing this, so that's why I didn't film it. I didn't plan on painting it detailed the way I did, but I did, and I think it looks pretty stinking cool. So the next step is to spray some more of this on it. Let's get it glossy, and then we'll be done. So I will show you the result. And there it is. Got the Kiwanuka yellow stripes. Up. And now let's do the spray. Okay, so after much thought and debate, after having this on my wall for about a week now, I've decided that the colors don't work. I love the colors, and in the right light, you can really see them. The black fading up to the blue, or down, anyway. And it's really beautiful in the right light, but you have to have the right light all the time on it, and it just doesn't work. So I have decided I'm going to paint this. I have bluebell, which I think is a little too dark, and black, which will help darken it up a little bit. And so I'm going to finish this piece of art up by painting it just a solid-ish color, and that way it'll stand out.
Check the mic and make sure it sound right, boys.
Okay, so we have finished that up. I've let it dry, and then I put a glossy kind of finishing on it. Now, the last thing I'm gonna do is engrave my signature right there. Never done this before, and to be honest, this Orator laser that I have is finicky at best. I have so many issues with it, it's not even funny, but every once in a while I get it to work and I like it when I do. So we're gonna try this out. So I have in Lightburn, I have my signature loaded up, and now I have to come over here and I have to focus that laser. So right there, you see how there's a line that's not good enough. It has to be more, it's gonna be a line, but it has to be a lot tighter, a lot more compressed. So we're gonna get that focused real quick.
How you focus it is you rotate the lens until it is as tight of a dot as you can get. And when you go too far, it starts going back up again. So we'll just get that right there.
All right, so just come over here to Lightburn. You like my purple computer? I bought a Fusion 5 tablet to go up here and it worked great for about a month and a half. So isn't that lovely? So I stole my wife's computer for now. It's beautiful and covered in sawdust. So that's good. The goal here is to get a nice burn on it without setting the whole thing on fire. You ready? Let's do it. And see if we could do it without having an alarm, because I often get alarms when I try this. And what I do whenever I'm engraving, I engrave the back of every one of my pieces with my website address and all that and logo. And if I get an alarm, well, I can just sand off that engraved part and do it again. Can't do that here. So it's gonna be interesting. Wish me luck. Here we go. 5, 4, 3, 2. I'm just pushing play. You have cut. Oh, already got an alarm. Hang on. Oh, I wish I had sprung for much better laser. We're just gonna go. Let's go. And already got another alarm. Alarm on our near line 4. So, this laser's not firing now. We've got a problem. And we're just gonna cut. We're already 5 minutes in that stupid montage. All right, we had it set once again, and let's see if we can make this work. No, stop. It's an IDIOT error. Yes, I do have my laser goggles on, by the way. Safety first. Can't do art if you don't have eyes. Okay, let's take a look at this without the laser goggles. And, well, why not? That looks pretty stinking cool. It shaved away a lot of the paint and went right down to the black undercoat, which I dig. So, pretty awesome. And here it is, guys, the finished product. I absolutely love it. He really is one of my favorite artists, and I can't wait to get this thing out of the garage so that I can stop wiping off sawdust. I'm like, you come into the shop and you're covered. That's just the way it is. You know, you have to understand, if you're gonna come to the Beardacus workshop, you're gonna get covered in sawdust. You know, I have all this dust collection system. It doesn't do anything. There's sawdust everywhere. That's okay. I really appreciate you guys sticking with me all the way to the end. This is a piece of art that, is it perfect? No. Do I care? No. I love it. It's going to hang up on my wall forever. One day my children are going to fight over it, and I'm not going to leave this in the will to my children. I'm going to let them fight over it. It's going to be fun. So, that got dark. Sorry, thanks for watching. I really appreciate it. Like, subscribe, share this video, hit the notification icon so that you'll be notified whenever I make more videos. And until next time, grow up. beard already.